Welcome to another tutorial of MATLAB. In this tutorial series, we are looking into the concept of stateflow and how to implement different concepts in stateflow. In the previous tutorial series, we have seen how to implement truth table and different concepts related to the aspect of truth table. In this particular video, we will be looking into Simulink functions and how we can use Simulink functions inside the stateflow environment. So let's get started with the same. To start stateflow, you need to type SF and press enter. So it will open the stateflow window, as you can see. Now you need to expand the main window and press on the space bar to make it visible properly. So you can first save the model first. So we will be saving it as Simulink function example, and just press on the space bar, it will expand. And let's drag the Simulink function now. So this is how the Simulink function looks like. And as you can see, we need to give it some name. So we are expecting Y from this particular Simulink function. And the function name that we are going to give here is add. So basically it will add two values. So those two values are A and B here. Now we will have a transition which will call this particular Simulink function. Okay, now let's call this particular function. So we can call it with the output. Outputs are usually represented with the help of curly braces in the stateflow environment. And you can call this function a comma b, add a comma b. And now we need to define the input and output for the stateflow chart. So first, double Y is the output that we need to mention in the model explorer. And along with that, we need to define A and B, right? So A is the input, B is the input. So both are the inputs, those will be added and you will get the Y as the output. Now we can close this and now let's define this function. So usually you will have a function block, as you can see here, and you will have the input and output in and out. So there are two in and one out in this particular model, and A and B are the in and Y is the out. So we will be just adding a small add block and to see the functionality check, and we will be done with this one. Now let's go to the top level of the chart and see how the inputs look like now. Now we can add constant blocks with different numbers. Either in this case, we will be having one and one are two constant that will be going inside the A and B as the input. And then we will be expecting a display block to show the Y outcome. So Y will show the outcome of this particular model stateflow chart. Now just press on the space bar, it will simulate the model. So